Hi, this is Graham from Jenham's Astro. In a recent video, we had a look at this telescope, the Celestron C90 Astro. This one was built in the late 1970s. Now, at the time, I summarized that I really liked the package, very solidly built, and you really wouldn't know that it was 45 years old. But no telescope can be admired just for how it looks. They have to work. They're actual optical instruments, after all. So in this follow-up, I'm going to take the optical tube off the mount, put it onto another telescope, and we're going to see if we can capture some images to get an idea of the optical quality of this particular example. Defogging the C90 really couldn't be easier. You just got three screws to remove and then the job is done. Okay, so I think it fits really well on the Evo 8 and looks like a nice smart setup. The only thing I've got to make sure is that with that extra weight of the C90, that I have adjust the position of the tube so that we don't get out of balance. Okay, ready to go. So first up, I put the ASI 224 camera directly onto the back of the C90, just with an adapter in between so I could adjust the barrel size. And I had a look at Jupiter, which is quite high in the sky in the early evening. I've used fire capture, which is my normal way of capturing raw video, and I guess the first thing to note was that the planet was quite small, but I could see the main equatorial bands. Then I processed it through ASI and Registax, and it produced a very pixelated image. So I guess, aside from the color cast, which seems a little bit off, it was sort of proof of concept that we could capture some detail, but this was the wrong image scale. So I dug out the 2.5x Barlow that came with the C90, the original piece of kit, and put that in the optical train, which made everything a little bit unwieldy. But at least Jupiter became a decent size in the frame. Very difficult to focus though. The helical focuser really moved the image around all over the place. But overall, I got, I guess, a fairly decent picture of Jupiter. Fairly happy with that. Lots of trial and error to get the focus though. Then we moved on to the planet Mars, which is obviously a smaller target. And in the evenings I tried, it was relatively low in the sky. It was just rising. And well, we caught some detail, really not the greatest image, but again, it's very difficult to focus the C90 and a small target. Okay, so moving on to the moon, I decided to take the C90 off the piggyback mount and put it onto a grab and go mount instead. And this time, initially, I hooked up a DSLR onto the back of the optical tube using yet another adapter. I was fortunate there was an occultation of the planet Mars early one morning by the moon. And in that case, I discovered more by luck than anything else that the moon, the full disc fits in the field of view of the C90. And you can see the planet Mars there, just a little orange dot on the upper left side of the image. So quite happy with that capture. Then going back to the ASI camera, caught some video of the moon. Obviously the whole of the disc doesn't fit in this case, but took some video and then put it through Registax and slightly probably wavelet-ed it to within an inch of its life, but gave a nice sharp image of, you can see the Bay of Rainbows there. And then looking at the highlands of the moon, along the Terminator there, again, see about half of the moon, and after processing, came up with quite a nice image, I think. Quite a lot of detail there from this 1000mm Maksutov. So I put the Barlow into the equation, and this is where things got difficult. Really quite tricky to focus here, but it's part of the experiment. So again, take some video, process it through Registax, and this one, well, you know, we can see a few craterlets there in the middle, but nothing too special there. And then finally, looking again at this dense crater field, a little bit of wobble there on the video, not quite a stable image really on the video. And then after processing, this is what I got, which again, quite happy with. There's a bit of a strange color cast. I don't know whether there's some aberration going on or something in processing, but you can see a bit of color that really shouldn't be there. But overall, I think it's a nice sharp capture. Okay, so would I recommend that you go and defork your old C90 Mac and use it for astrophotography? Well, overall, I'd say no. It is more in the category of a challenge rather than a pleasure. Now, on the positive, I think the optical quality of this little scope, I think we've seen it is actually pretty good. But is it an easy scope to use for capturing planets? Definitely not. A combination of this famous focuser and the 0.965 diameter accessories really makes it a little bit cumbersome. And certainly when I used it, it made me really long for the 1.25 inch accessories and an ADC that I'd normally use to go photographing Jupiter. Nonetheless, I think we've seen on the moon, get some nice pictures. And basically, I think my summary is that this is a really good little spotting scope. Definitely consider taking off a fork mount if you've got one in the drawer, in a box somewhere, and set it up as a grab and go scope. It can produce really sharp images of the moon, and I think that's really, really where its niche is. So just over a kilo, if you can put up with the accessory size, or if you're lucky enough to have either a hybrid diagonal or an accessory ring to convert to 1.25 accessories, then I would say put it on a tripod and use it as a spotting scope, which of course it was sold. That is one of the variants of this scope, was a spotting scope originally. And yeah, it's pretty good for that. Okay, so I hope this video has been interesting. If you haven't subscribed to Jenham's Astro, then please hit the subscribe button now and look out for future videos from my channel. Okay, thanks for watching.